Whether you're buying a home or getting ready to put yours on the market, choosing the right realtor is a crucial part of the process.
We're here to help us, Nancy Braun with Showcase Realty. Hello, Nancy. How are you doing?
I'm great. Thank you.
We're glad you're here. All right. We mentioned choosing a realtor is really important. It's a great first step when buying or selling a home, correct?
That's absolutely one of the top things that people concern themselves with. Who are they going to have represent them?
Mm-hmm. Now, you've got 25 questions that you say are absolutely critical when buying a house.
That's right.
Okay, and the very first one is, how many homes have you sold?
That's right. Anyone can get a license with a minimal degree. It's like 6 or 8 weeks to train to get a certification and be a licensed realtor. And the question is, do you want to have someone that's had very little experience in the past or has sold thousands or hundreds of homes? Because each time you have a transaction, you have tremendous learning experience and there's problems that you have to solve throughout.
You also say one of the questions you can ask a potential realtor is, you know, where do you rank in Charlotte? Why is that a good question to ask?
Well, just to give you more experience. You want to be with someone that's out there, that knows the neighborhoods, that knows the product, knows the concerns, knows issues that might be specific to a certain area. You know, if radon is an issue or if aluminum wiring is an issue, an experienced agent's going to really have his or her hands on the local area and know all those critical factors.
Makes a lot of sense.
Yeah, and I know another thing is the list price to sell ratio. That has to be an issue that people have to bring up. Is that correct?
That's right. So there's, we call them in the industry, limited service brokers or discount brokers, and they might promote that they might be less of a commission. And you might be so focused on what kind of commission they're going to charge, but the end result is, what are you going to net? So if you're putting your home on the market, it doesn't really matter so much what you're paying to get your home marketed, as long as you net more. Mm-hmm. So if I take my home on the market and I engage a realtor that maybe isn't going to market the property or isn't going to use all the tools that they should be using to blast it on the internet or get great photography, and then they put the house on the market and they get 85% to list price, well, I've really lost my money, even though I think I'm saving it on the front end by paying less commission, because if you went with someone like myself, we get 100% on average of list price.
That's good to know. Another question that folks should ask when they're choosing a realtor is asking the agent how many buyers they're working with. Why is that an important question to ask?
Well, the typical real estate agent is most often working with 2 or 3 buyers at any one time. And when I've created a system in our office, so we actually have 5 people answering the phones, and we're heavy marketers, so we have over 50,000 buyers in our database. So I tell my sellers, I probably already have your home sold.
So with those 50,000 people in your database, what is the marketing plan? Because that would be the next thing I want to know. What is the marketing plan as you're going to sell my home?
Oh, well, we have a tremendous marketing team. So I have people on my staff that are experts in social media, in digital marketing, in SEO. We also have a very, very sophisticated CRM, so we can market the properties to our database right away. So they immediately get access to our new listings and our open houses, price reductions, and any new back on the market, they'll be notified right away.
Another thing you can ask a realtor that you might be considering working with is how many homes they sold last year.
That's right, yes. So that way you know, are they up and coming, are they engaged in the business, or are they just part-time? Mm-hmm. But the person that's out there that's marketing and selling a lot of homes is going to be very knowledgeable.
See, I think a lot of times people don't ask these questions. They just think, oh, my friend said that his cousin just got his license, and now he's going to be my guy. But this makes so much sense to me, Nancy. Mm-hmm. You mentioned you have a large staff at Showcase Realty. Mm-hmm. It's another question that you can ask a realtor that you might be thinking about working with. What is the size of your staff?
Right, right. So I was an individual agent for a general brokerage my first 12 years in my career. And then in 2008, I spun off and created my own company. And the reason was I felt that I couldn't service my sellers in particular unless I had a big team behind me, because the internet was exploding. Mm-hmm. And even though I'm good on social media and I'm good at technology, I can't possibly by myself market the properties all by myself. I don't have enough hands or fingers to type and create that. So my team behind me is marketing and blasting the properties that we have for the market all over the internet. And if you don't have that kind of expertise and the people that can back you up and really properly market your property, you might not be getting the exposure that you need to sell your house.
Telling you, you're good. You're good, Nancy. If you would like a free copy of Nancy's 25 critical questions you must ask your agent before hiring them, visit ncbestagent.com, ncbestagent.com. Nancy Braun from Showcase Realty, thank you for your time.
Thank you. Thank you.